Stop letting society tell you about the best skincare routines, the hottest plastic surgeons, or the cream that will keep your skin from aging. It's time we start asking ourselves, what the fuck is beauty anyway? If we remove all the IG filters, is there more to a beautiful face than just skincare? Well, I'm here to share it with you, and hell yeah, there is. My name is Jen Carrasco. I have been an esthetician, as well as a high-level fitness competitor, and an all-around badass for over a decade. And I need you to know there is way more to keeping your mind and body clean than just a cream. Join me each week as I cut the BS out of getting healthy, caring for ourselves, and caring for our skin. I share real tips, real ingredients, and real experience. Now let's get some answers on what the fuck is beauty anyway. What's up, guys? It is Jen Carrasco with What the Fuck is Beauty Anyway? So my sidekick and bestie is not with me today. So I am doing this on my own with my main man, Duke Diggler, my English bulldog. So you might hear him bark throughout the thing, but he is part of the episode. So anyway, I thought today I would go over a little bit more about skincare and a little bit more on the ingredients versus just going in a little bit with what you should be doing every single day. So we'll do that on another podcast about what I think is definitely beneficial for you to be using morning, noon, and night and how you should be doing the things. But I got a little bit of feedback and I got some people asking me because especially with my patients, they have a lot of skincare problems. So over 20 years of being in the skincare industry and permanent makeup, tattoo removal, and body treatments, I have found a lot of issues as far as allergies and what is in people's skincare and what is actually causing a lot of harm to our bodies and our skin. So you have to think that our skin is actually the largest organ. So being the largest organ, it is going to pretty much take in anything that you put on it. So whatever you put on your skin is going to get absorbed. So a lot of times I'll have clients coming in for an eyebrow wax, and it's mandatory now that I have my estheticians that work for me. They ask if they're on retin-A's or any type of exfoliant products, because what happens is when we wax them, we will pull up skin with their eyebrows. And there's a plus side to that, with the plus side being is that you actually get a little bit of an eye lift, which is a great thing, but nobody wants to have red swollen eyes that kind of get a crust over them and have to peel off. So the reason why I say that is because I have a lot of clients or patients that come back to me and they say, I'm not using anything. I'm only using retinol, or I'm using a vitamin A, or I'm using a salicylic acid, but I'm putting it on my face, but not on my eyebrows. Thing is that your skin is the largest organ, so it is going to take it everywhere. So regardless if you put it on your forehead or not, it's going to be absorbed in the eye area. So definitely note to self, if you go and get waxed, you should definitely tell your esthetician or beautician who is waxing you that you are on some type of a retinol or acid or anything of that form. So anyway, today I'm going to go over a lot of the ingredients that are definitely dirty ingredients to avoid in your skincare. So my suggestion is, I think you should go through all of your products, look at what's in there, look at the ingredients, and it's just like what you get when you go grocery shopping. So I know a lot of us look in ingredients now and we see what's in there and we see, you know, how much sugar, how much carbs, or, you know, what we are pretty much putting into our bodies. So I'm going to go over a little bit more with skincare and what we put into our skin, which gets absorbed into our bodies. So let's get started with all of the ingredients. So I do want to go over a little bit as far as the absorption in our bodies. A lot of people don't understand that our skin and body will actually absorb about 60% of what we put on it. So that can, you know, definitely be a negative or a positive, but just know that a lot of the ingredients that can be harmful are definitely in our face washes, lotions, sunscreen, and a lot of them will produce allergies as far as eczema, you'll get cancer, hormone disruption, and reproductive problems. So really understand the ingredients that are going in there. Another thing is too, is if you thought that the FDA does a superb job at regulating what goes into our food and supply, you'll be equally appalled to know that they do not regulate shit in our cosmetics, personal care, hair care products in general. The same way you look at food labels, you should also be doing the same for your beauty products. There are thousands of chemicals in your products, many of which are being absorbed. These companies have a lot of ways to get ingredients in there without government review or approval. The industry is highly unregulated, and there is no pre-product approval before products hit the market and they enter your home. So let's run down my couple of lists that I have for you guys. So the first one I'm going to talk about is going to be aluminum. So this product actually has a lot of estrogenic-like effects in our system. It is a toxic metal, and it will disrupt our healthy function of our endocrine system. It's usually found in a lot of personal care, especially antiperspirants and deodorants. The second one that is on my list is DEA, MEA, and TEA. Don't ask me to spell them because I have no freaking clue how to pronounce them. So anyway, just know that they are usually found in a lot of eye makeup, fragrances, hair products, and sunscreens. These products are clear, colorless, and with ammonia-like odors. Also, the next one is going to be mineral oil. So a lot of people say that oil is really good for your skin. It breaks down, oil breaks down oil, but just know that a mineral oil is completely different. It is a petroleum-like byproduct. So what it's going to do is actually going to coat the skin almost like a plastic, clogging your pores. This is incredibly harmful, and the reason why is because it interferes with the skin's ability to eliminate toxins. So your skin's reasoning for having cells and oil and all of that is to eliminate toxins in your body. So of course we discrete them in the fucking bathroom, but a lot of times when you're having problems, you know, you definitely swell up, your tissues swell up. You notice like if you get sick, you tend to have like hot flashes or heat. It's the way that your body eliminates toxins. So therefore, it also increases the likelihood of acne and other skin disorders. So know that mineral oil is found a lot in creams, lotion, ointments, and it's in cosmetics. The next one that I really want to go over is parabens. So I want to say that a lot of people out there say, oh, it's okay to use parabens. Parabens are okay. They have a bad name. Well, guess what? Parabens are not good. Methyl, butyl, ethyl, propyl, though not good for your skin. The reason why is a lot of times it will contribute to a hormone imbalance. Having a hormone imbalance in your skin will produce acne. It can produce hyperpigmentation. You can have a lot of issues with hormone balance. So parabens are used as a preservative. So that's what preserves your products. So you need to definitely look at other companies that do not use them. I highly say stay away from them. It's also found in cleansers and it dissolves the oil and grease. So anyway, the next one is going to be propylene glycol and butylene glycol. These are actually hydrocarbons, and what they do is they act as a surfactant. So they penetrate the skin so quickly that can actually weaken the protein and cellular structure of your tissues or your cells. So when you weaken the protein and the cellular structure, you're actually causing more damage and you're causing your skin to actually age faster. So just know that you're going to get this great skincare, but it's gonna have propylene glycol. So it says anti-aging, but matter of fact, it's fucking aging you. So just do your research. What you put on your skin, what you put in your body makes a fucking difference, a huge difference. So I cannot explain this enough. When people ask me what I do to my skincare or on my skin, I am 40 years old. So I have been taking care of my skin since I was younger. Probably, I think I started 13, 14 years old. My mom got me into, I think it was Mary Kay back then, and I started that. And the thing is that nowadays, I want to say probably about in my 30s, I started certain things in my skincare. So I definitely did a vitamin C. I did some sort of a vitamin A, and we'll go over vitamin A on a different podcast because that's super beneficial. Anti-aging ingredients, vitamin C, vitamin A, but there's different forms of vitamin A that are actually really good for your skin. So with taking care of my skin, honestly, I only really use 3 ingredients in the morning and 3 ingredients at night. You do not need a lot. You just need products that actually work, that don't have shit in them. That's pretty much where it boils down. So let me see. I have my list going of everything that I really wanted to go over with you guys today. So my next one that I want to talk about is synthetic fragrances. So synthetic fragrances are a huge red flag. The reason why is because a lot of the companies, they pretty much put this in their ingredients and it's pretty much an artificial ingredient. So it's synthetic and it's an artificial and it's a huge red flag. So it's in thousands of products and usually you find them in a lot of your household products, candles, air fresheners, and it's even in your scented trash bags. So definitely pay attention to that. The next one that I think is absolutely huge is sodium lauryl sulfate, also known as sodium lauryl sulfate, which is SLES and SLS. So this is in 90% of our skincare products that foam, lather, and bubble. The reason why I think this one is so harmful for you is that it actually will dehydrate the tissues of your skin. So it's in a lot of shampoos now. There's a lot of them coming out that are more natural that don't have them in there. And I should do a list of like all of the hair products that don't combine them into their products or into their ingredients. But this product has a foaming agent. And with the foaming agent in our brains, we think, okay, if we're foaming, we're getting clean, we're getting squeaky clean. That's kind of what we've always been taught. And it's totally not the case with our skin. So it's a major concern because it actually is known to actually cause lung, skin, and eye irritants. It's a surfactant and it also is a chemical that is completely carcinogenic. So know that when you're working it into the tissue of the skin, it will dehydrate the tissue of the skin, especially like your hair follicles. So then your hair follicles are dry, your skin is dry, you can't produce hair properly because it's getting trapped underneath there. And so a lot of times your production of hair definitely starts to fall out. And the reason why I'm so passionate about this one ingredient is because I see it all the time with my clients. They'll come in and they say, I don't understand. I'm using a great cleanser. I cleanse my skin, you know, morning and night, and I do it twice at night, like, you know, I'm supposed to. And I say, bring in your ingredients or bring in your products and let me look at your ingredients. So I look at their ingredients and that is the number one ingredient in most of the products. And the thing is that it dehydrates your tissues and it's an irritant. So they actually put this in products to cause irritation to see if people get allergic to certain things because it causes an allergic reaction in people. And so what happens is it dehydrates the tissue of the skin. And dehydrating the tissue of the skin makes you feel like you need moisture. So it's a catch-22. So the industry is dehydrating the tissues of your skin to make you feel like you need to go and buy their moisturizer that goes into the skin. But honestly, nobody really needs a moisturizer. And we'll get into that on a different episode. But just know when you look for a cleanser, make sure that it does not have a sodium lauryl sulfate in it at all. It is actually in mascara, body washes, shampoos, cleansers. The reason behind that is it will dehydrate and it will make it completely irritable. So if your lashes are starting to fall out or they're getting dry, they're getting brittle, look at what is in the product, what you are putting on your skin. So the next thing that I do want to go over is phthalate. Phthalate is a chemical that is used in products to increase the flexibility and softness of, guess what? Plastics. So the main phthalate in cosmetic personal care products are definitely in nail polish. It is in perfumes, lotions, and in hairspray. So also known that it is also an endocrine disruptor and is also increased the risk of breast cancer. So just know, make a list, go through your stuff. Really, you guys, be an advocate. There's no reason why you should have dry, flaky skin. There's Google, there's so many other things out there to really do your research before you start spending a slew of money on products that are completely going to start aging you. The next one is going to be triclosan. Triclosan is in a lot of antimicrobial chemicals. So it's in a lot of the antibacterial lotions and stuff that are out there. And there's a lot of controversy about that just because people use it to disinfect their hands. But they don't seem to understand that when you're using that, you're killing the majority of the bacteria that's on there, and it could be good or bad bacteria, but you are making your skin more susceptible to bacteria because you're killing bacteria that helps your immune system. So just know that when you're using cleansers and things like that that have that in it, it's not doing you a great service. So it's something you definitely want to look at. Another thing we're gonna go over is formaldehyde, which of course you really don't want to put that on your skin, but it definitely is in a lot of skincare. So it is preservatives and it's used in cosmetic products to help prevent bacterial growth. So the one thing that they're finding out with this is the research that it's producing on carcinogens. It's also been linked to a lot of related cancers, which is also a nasal cancer, which is crazy, but skin reactions, and it also is extremely harmful for your immune system. It is found actually in a lot of nail polish, body washes, conditioners, shampoos, cleansers, eyeshadows, and nail polish treatments. So the next one that we are going to go over is a propylene glycol. I see this in a lot of products. So it's a small organic alcohol and it's commonly used for skin conditioning agents. So I want you to go and look at your moisturizers because I have to tell you that every single product that I've looked at and bringing in to my facility, they have all had a propylene glycol. So it is a huge skin irritant and penetrator. It's been caught or it's associated a lot with causing dermatitis and hives with humans. So just know it's called propylene glycol. I bet you anything you're gonna find it in a lot of your stuff, especially moisturizers, sunscreens, and a lot of conditioners and shampoos, even some hairsprays. So the next thing I do want to go over is sunscreens. This is definitely a controversial because we definitely need to use a sunscreen. We definitely want something to absorb all the ultraviolet lights as well as the the sun outside. So the chemicals in sunscreens, they definitely will mess up, which would be our endocrine disruptors, and easily desorbed into the body. They also cause cellular damage and cancer in the body. So common names are benzophene, PABA. Don't judge me with my pronunciations. Avobenzone, homos. Anyway, I'll write them down on my YouTube channel for you guys. I cannot pronounce them. They can be found in a lot of the sunscreens, so you definitely need to make sure the chemicals in the sunscreens. I make sure that my sunscreens really only have a base of a couple products that are more natural, which is would be like your zinc, things like that, that you need to look for. Just know that I'm saying this for your well-being. There's a lot of products, you know, you definitely can't avoid every single synthetic chemical that you come in contact with, but just limit it, you know, be your advocate and know exactly how many toxins that you are getting exposed to, you know, make sure that you're eating clean food, that you're avoiding chemical foods, you're drinking filtered water. Look for products, you know, they will say certified organic, but definitely make sure that these products, they don't have chemicals in them and toxic chemicals. You know, make sure that your esthetician knows a lot about our ingredients or what you're getting. But anyway, you guys, you can follow me on Jen IFBB Pro. I also have a YouTube channel. It's Jen IFBB Pro, I believe. And my Facebook is Jennifer Carrasco. I do have a Twitter account. I'm not too active on there, but I'm definitely going to be writing a post about my skincare products. And I'm going to write about all the ingredients in there. So that way you guys have a printable list that you can look at. I really am passionate about not just skincare, but I'm passionate about definitely food, what you're putting in your body, what you're doing, what you do inside your body and outside of your body is going to make a difference with whom you are. And it's even going to make a difference with your mindset. I really truly feel that a lot of it makes a difference with you being negative or positive in life. And, you know, we need to be healthy. We want to live as long as we can. And that's why we do everything we do. And that's why we eat healthy. That's why we work out. We do all these things to be better people. And I'm here because I want to educate you. And I want you to be a better you and a better individual. And that's why I'm put on earth. I'm put on earth to help others and to educate others. So if you guys ever need anything, please follow me on Instagram, DM me, ask me questions, shoot me some emails. So anyway, with that, it was a great podcast. I know this is my only first couple podcasts, so I'm getting used to it, so bear with me. Other than that, have a fabulous rest of your day, or evening, or morning, wherever time period you're at. And follow me because we are going to be posting these weekly with weekly updates, and I'm going to change them every week with different things. We might go over skincare, we might go over mindset, we might go over training, we might go over health, we might go over personal shit. But whatever you guys are interested in, anything you want to know, just get back to me on it, and I would love to shoot an education podcast over that. So anyway, have a fabulous time or day, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye. Thanks for tuning in this week. I hope you feel more empowered and more inspired to love the skin you're in. As we navigate new society norms and beauty daily, make sure to always ask yourself, what the fuck is beauty to me? And know that's all that matters. If you love this content today, make sure to subscribe, rate, and review. Follow me and get more info on my guests at viragostudio.com. Yes, I said it, viragostudio.com. And that's the shit. See you on the next episode, beauties.